are mad enough to do it. Hunger!
Thanks.
Oh no, that's totally not fair. No, no, no!
Brave veterans, can you stand the pace?
We're fine, thank you. Though we're not quite as young as we used to be.
Well, I see. A beauty in the prime of her life.
Well, I'm 715 years old. Winston is 12 years older.
She has aged splendidly, my dear little lotus blossom.
You with a sweet talk.
L'amour. The heroism of the tortoises has saved us all. But without water, all that awaits us is certain death. And we are doomed if we go back to free Socrates and release the water. We are much too weak.
Then we have to get help. We'll call all the animals of the savannah.
Excellent, weasel.
Daddy, what are you doing with the lion?
Maya, Daddy has no time for this right now.
Set the lion free right now.
But it's not possible. There's nothing I can do. The lion is dangerous, and we can't just let it loose to run around all over the place. And besides, I've already sold the lion to a casino in Las Vegas.
You have successfully penetrated the security zone. While your friends have disappeared in the drink, you, looks like you're the lucky one. Smith sold you to a casino in Las Vegas.
Las what?
You hit the jackpot, top of the mountain. I've always dreamed of doing an appearance in Las Vegas just once.
I'm not hungry. Drink. It'll taste a lot better. Mom, did you have something to drink?
Of course I did.
You're a really bad liar, you know.
Junior.
This is my waterhole, crocodile bait.
No.
You go find your own puddle, see? Or you can bite my horn!
Instead, I'll use your horn as a toenail clipper, okay?
You're asking for it!
£300 and not an ounce of brain, fat heads.
Thank you.
old sweetheart.
To do?
Nope.
No.
Have you ever thought why you two are fighting in the first place?
Naturally. Because. Because. Why do you think, Biggie?
Hey, I don't know.
Just as I thought. So from now on, go and play your juvenile game somewhere else. Got it?
Let's go talk to Angie. Angie's actually the president of Okavango.
A female president, Why not? I will attempt a bit of diplomacy with her, the way I know how.
My skin is utterly and completely dried out. My nails are all cracked. My complexion, ruined. My lashes are like barbed wire. The end is near.
Giselle! We've got other things to worry about.
Oh, well, that's charming. I'm falling apart and you say we've got other things to worry about.
Oh, huh? Do not despair, madame.
Oh, no. I hear voices. Oh, I know this is the end. And I look like such a mess.
Hello. The name is Charles.
Charles? My, what a lovely name.
By the way, the oppressive heat can do nothing to hide your noble and sublime beauty.
Oh,
If I may be so bold, you seem to have been blessed with a delightful nose. So soft, and the most silky trunk.
Pooh, go marry her then.
We must call a conference, tout de suite.
A conference?
A gathering of all the animals. There, we must figure out how this hero of yours was able to discover the water.
I have a hero? Who is it?
Yoo-hoo!
Billy? Then someone's got to blow the great horn.
There's a great gathering of the animals in 2 hours called a conference. You don't want to be late.
I'm on my way. Let's see. 2 hours. I know I can do it. Thank heaven for shortcuts.
Well, look who's here. It's the lightweight.
Yeah, Miggy. What's so funny, Geritop, eh?
We are all gathered together to discuss our precarious situation. And as you all may know, this is our first great historical animal gathering. For the duration of the proceedings, none of you will inflict harm upon another.
Fine by me.
If I may, the meerkats only really count as snacks, correct?
No one is allowed to touch anyone.
Eh?
Billy, your report?
Yeah, so here's the scoop. I found the water. Cool.
Who cares what that worm has to say? He's nothing but a squash fly on my hoof, see?
Problem is, the water's trapped way up in Leopard Canyon by these massive stones.
It was the leopard.
No, it was because of a bunch of strange, horribly ugly creatures, naked without any fur.
Ugh, that's gross.
We're talking bloodthirsty, awful beasts. They call themselves humans.
What a pile of garbage. And since when did we ever listen to the drivel from a meerkat?
Chino is a dumb buffalo, but for once, he's got a point.
Mon ami, this, well, meerkat has shown more courage than all of you combined.
Those are some big words coming from you.
You little half-pint.
Do you have any idea what this little half-pint has been through? Do you know just how many of my comrades I have lost? The things I have seen from a dark dungeon, where my kind and I were locked up only to languish in the smallest of cells while wondering if we were to end up on a skewer, or perhaps a burgundy sauce. Mankind treats us like animals!
Well, that certainly was clear as mud.
And that's why we have to do something! We have to free up the water now!
Correct me if I'm wrong, but doesn't that mean we have to go through the Valley of Death? The water has always come, and it will come this time. We just have to wait.
The water is not simply water.
It is the blood of our forefathers.
Come on, what's with these two old-timers?
These two tortoises know mankind better than any other alive. And of course, much, much longer.
Good
evening.
My name is Winston, and...
I am called Winifred. We were born more than 700 years ago.
On an island located deep within the Pacific Ocean.
In all that time, we have come across many human beings.
They have stolen and have murdered.
And destroyed everything many, many times. And we let it happen. And because of this, we have lost everything. Our beloved home is sadly no more. Where once were blooming flowers of all colors, is now dry and arid. Where once the very air vibrated with the twittering of thousands of kinds of birds, is now only silence. Where once seals and the beasts of the ocean bobbed in the waves, all life is now at an end. Galapagos, our wondrous home, is now little more than a wretched, black, dark, and oily mass. The entire world is nothing more than a black, dark, and oily mass. Except for this place here. But if you do nothing to stop it, this place too will become no more than a blackened stain. For man is a thief who comes in the night and takes what he wants from the land. He is like a snake who eats his own tail to survive. But the earth does not belong to man. He is only a tiny part of it. Man did not weave the fabric of life. He's but a thread within it. For we all share the same breath. The rising mists of the lush green forests, the refreshment of the rocky mountain breezes, the perfumed scent of the wind after a cooling shower of rain, the plants, man, and we, the animals. What man doesn't realize is what he does to the land. He ultimately does to himself. And when the land is finally destroyed, and the animals are either driven out or killed, man will rule over the earth, alone. Then lost and forlorn, he too will be wiped from the face of the earth. But that is a cold comfort to us now. For every one of you will perish if you don't defend yourselves against humanity.
Spoke wisely and with great care.
Well, that's because they were your thoughts that I spoke.
What you spoke was greater than every thought.
And still all meaningless compared to my many years with you. Our years together. It's been wonderful. Good. So good.
Winnie? Winnie?
Winston and Winifred have gone to sleep for the last time. But they live on in all of our dreams and in our hearts.
The tortoises have passed away.
Madame, we are waiting on your command.
But shouldn't we consult the Oracle first?
I don't think so, dear. Been there, done that. So, to battle!
And down with the beast!
And down with the beast!
Allons, et vive la liberté!
Could have done is consult the Oracle. I get no respect. What happened to tradition? It's a disgrace.
Did you hear what I heard?
We've all been asking for advice from that guy. A hairdresser who talks from both sides of his mouth at the same time.
Sure, madame. It is a true honor to be allowed to march with you.
Yes, we're proud, but are we strong enough? Remember, the buffalo and the rhino didn't come along.
The heroic courage of our brave soldiers will make up for them.
Socrates, hang in there. We're coming.
About those who don't have a banana milkshake. Or a drop of water.
Hey, I can read you like a book. You want to make me feel all guilty so that I'll help you escape. But you're wasting your time. I can't do anything. The big guy with the rifle's got the key to the cage.
Here I am, confined to a cage. But yet somehow I remain free. You're outside. But you are not really free at all. Are you?
So, duty calls.
Just go. Playing monkey must be fun.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Left foot!
You put your left foot in, you put your left foot out, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Meat eater! One can tell by that unpleasant breath. And have a little respect. Just look at yourself. Stand up straight! Chest out! And why are you so late? What kind of discipline is that for a soldier? And take your incredibly filthy paws off my uniform. To your unit! This year, please.
Everything all right, my brave hero?
But of course, I simply had to reprimand a cowardly deserter.
Showtime!